So good morning to all of you. I'm very glad to be here to talk to you, to the younger generation in Asia, so most probably to the future of the world. So thank you for taking the time to listen to me. So first I will take a bit of time to introduce myself. So I'm Philippe Bancaterneuf. I'm the managing director of a brand new branch of BITC Construction Group in Singapore called Six Sense Asia Singapore. So maybe you don't know really about BITC. So this is our latest major achievement in the world. I guess it's a place where you never spend any holidays because it's the site of the Chernobyl nuclear plant in Ukraine, which collapsed in 1986. Our job there, in the frame of the JV Novaca, was to build the confinement for the nuclear reactor. And that's what we did, so you can see the confinement prepared here. It's quite a huge structure, because let's say it occupies something like 4 hectares, so very massive area, high like a 30-story building. And what we assembled it in the side of the reactor, and in last November we pushed it by 300 meters to cover the reactor so that we can avoid any leak of nuclear radiation. So that's our latest major achievement in the world, and we are very proud of achieving this. But not only in Ukraine but also in Asia, so we are based in nearly every country in Southeast Asia with different branches, with roughly 3,000 to 4,000 employees in Southeast Asia and Hong Kong. So we'll not give too much into detail, just to give you a few recent references we have. So maybe there are some people from Cambodia here. So to come here, you use some infrastructure that we are currently running. So we are running with the three international ports in Cambodia, in Siem Reap, in Phnom Penh, and in Sihanoukville. And as we operate it, we also build the recent extensions of them with our general contracting grant VINCI construction grant projects based in Malaysia, active not only in Malaysia but also in Cambodia, in Vietnam, in Indonesia. Another recent reference we have, so it's in Singapore. We are well known with our subsidiary Batchy Seletange as a very good contractor for underground works, active mainly in MRT construction. So Singapore is a good place to build MRT. So I chose this picture because we are currently building the gardens by the base in the MRT station. But on the backstage you can see the Marina Bay Sands Tower. I think this, even here in Bangkok, this building is quite famous. And a few years ago, we built the foundation of this tower as well. Another branch that we have, speaking about MRT, is called Fresine, active in crystallizing technologies, present here in Bangkok with a huge branch of 900 people. And I chose this picture because it's nice. It's not here in Bangkok, it's in Vietnam. So a few months ago, you could see this political poster in the streets of Ho Chi Minh City. Maybe there are people from Ho Chi Minh City here? Or whether from Vietnam? Sorry?
Hanoi.
Hanoi. Hanoi. We are not building the Hanoi one. Sorry. So the People's Committee in Ho Chi Minh City was so happy with what we are currently doing that they used a picture, artistic picture of the site we are currently doing, so on the segment viaducts of the MRT, to illustrate the good work, the good policies of the Ho Chi Minh City People's Committee. And last but not least, another thing we did in Singapore a few months ago is the design and the commissioning of the Jurong Road Caverns. So this one you have no chance to have seen it because it's 130 meters under the level of the sea. These caverns are a huge mine structure of 20 meters wide, 30 meters high and 300 meters long. So, especially with the quite bad light in this room, you have no chance to figure yourself what it is about. And whatever, there is no picture that can give you the feeling that you have when you have entered these structures. But no, you cannot feel anymore because it's closed and should now be filled with what they are in for, meaning storing some oil. So, this is about us. I must say, I don't have the ambition today speaking to you to give you some theoretical advice about what should be innovation, what should be an innovation process. I just want to share with you, in our position of a world-leading construction company, what we are currently doing innovation and what are the fields in which we are working for this. What we have to take into account, what we have to take note of, is first that the world is changing. And I think the main change in the world in the, let's say, 50 to 70 years is that the world of IT has changed. First of all, how our ability to store and to manage data. It's very impressive for me to notice, very amazing, to notice that the first computers built in the 50s and 60s, so the computers that computed nuclear weapons and the computer later that sent people to the moon were less powerful, actually, than this thing. And this has completely changed our relation with data. So not only the ability to store and to manage data, but also the capability to access and then to create data. Now, I remember I grew up in France. I got my first phone in my flat when I was a student in France in 98. I got my first handphone when I was a student once again in 2001. In 2007, I got my first smartphone. And now I think I'm completely unable to live without that. And I travel quite a lot. When I travel, the only things I check I have with me is my credit card, my passport, and my phone. So this has completely changed the way our relation with data. And we're speaking about going digital, we're speaking about data in construction quite quickly. We speak about BIM, BIM, Building Information Modeling. I guess if you are here, means that you are interested in engineering, and being interested in engineering now is difficult not to hear at least about BIM. But sorry, I will once again be prepared to give you a definition, our definition of what is it or what it should be. So in general, when you make a project, when you have a building to build, you have many sources of information. First of them is to describe the geometry of what you are building. So meaning what is its shape, what are the dimensions, and where it is located. Usually all this is described in drawings. In addition to that, you have the description, the formal description of what this thing is purpose to do, which material it uses, and so on. And this is described in texts. And last but not least, to build a project, to proceed to a project, we need to use lots of figures, lots of information about resources. And all these figures are mainly compiled in Excel files, very simple. Excel, I think, is the most useful software for engineers. And this is related with a very top-down workflow, meaning that first you have the client who will write a program, then it goes to architect and consultancies who will give a shape to this program to make a real project, then go to a contractor who will build it, and then to operators and at least end users. The problem is, this way of working, that in general, all these databases are not consistent. They are not consistent because people don't do properly their work. They are not consistent because they don't focus on the same priorities, meaning the client will focus on the description of the program. Then the architect will take the program and focus on making drawings. Then also on to consultancies, and to the builder will focus on figures. So, as we all have limited time and can only focus on our priorities, this will end to inconsistent databases. And the consequence of this will be lots of frustration and misunderstandings that will lead to clashes between people, not only between databases. and this is a meeting. So what is the purpose of BIM? It's to say, okay, I cannot describe a project without these three databases. But now I have a more powerful computer than what I used to have. I can put everything inside the database, inside the same database, the shared database. And as I have a powerful computer, what I can do is saying that this database will take the form that will be the most easy to read, meaning a 3D model. And now that I have a single database, it's more convenient that instead of having a top-down workflow, it's more convenient that everyone works on the same database, in the same database in a collaborative way. This doesn't mean that everyone is involved from scratch to the very end of the project, but this means that you enter more smoothly and then retract more smoothly from the working process. So BIM, it began a few years ago in France. The first project for which we applied BIM massively in France was this one. So this was a quite early representation of our tubes and pipes. It was this project. I will show it bigger because I spent 5 years on this project in Paris. This is a museum for Louis Vuitton. And I'm very proud of it, and it was a huge technical success, and financially just a success.